For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Sales Report from your Sample Files folder. When data is arranged in a block, as it is in the Sales Report, it's referred to as a range. You'll often want to select a row or a column within a range, or even the entire range. Now, I did that very quickly, but this is a very small range. It only has 5 columns and 16 rows. But you'll often work with huge ranges, perhaps encompassing hundreds or even thousands of rows and columns. And selecting using the mouse would be very tedious. In this lesson, you'll learn how to select range rows, range columns, and entire ranges with a few clicks of the mouse or a few key presses on the keyboard. Let's begin by considering the problem of selecting all of the cells in row 7 that are also within the range. To do that, I'll begin by clicking in cell A7. I'll then hover the cursor carefully over the right-hand border of the selected cell until I see the four-headed arrow cursor shape. Now be very careful that you don't see the black cross cursor shape. We'll be using that cursor shape later in this session. You need the four-headed arrow cursor shape. When you're sure that you have the four-headed arrow cursor shape, hold down the Shift key on the keyboard and double-click with the mouse. And all of the cells in row 7 that are also within the range are now selected. Selecting a column within a range is very similar. I'll now select all of the cells in column C that are also within the range. To do that, I click on cell C3, hover over the bottom border until I see that four-headed arrow, hold down the Shift key and double-click. And you can see that I've now selected all of the cells in column C that are also within the range. Now let's consider selecting the entire range, including the header row. By the header row, I mean row 3, that has the column headers for the data in each of the columns of the range. So I'll begin by clicking in cell A3, then I hover over the right-hand border of the selected cell until I see that four-headed arrow cursor shape, hold down the Shift key on the keyboard and double-click. Now I hover over the bottom border of the selected cells until I see that four-headed arrow cursor shape, hold down the Shift key and double-click once more. And you can see that I've now selected all of the cells, including the header row. To select all of the cells excluding the header row, I'd simply start in cell A4 and then do exactly the same thing. So you now know how to select rows and columns within a range and an entire range using the mouse. But the keyboard method is even more powerful. Let's try that first problem, selecting all of the cells in row 7 that are also within the range, this time using the keyboard. So I'll use the arrow keys on the keyboard first of all to move to cell A7. Then I hold down Control and Shift together on the keyboard and then press the right arrow key. To select all of the cells in column C that are also within the range, I'll use the arrow keys to navigate to cell C3. Then I hold down Control Shift and press the down arrow key. Now let's think about selecting every cell in the range, including the header row. This is extremely easy, because there's a keyboard shortcut for this. That's Control A. You can think of the A as standing for all. So I'll hold down the Control key, press the A key, and you can see that I've selected the entire range. Now let's think about selecting the entire range excluding the header row. I'll press the up arrow key a couple of times and the left arrow key a couple of times to move to cell A4. Now I hold down Control Shift on the keyboard and right arrow key. And still holding down Control and Shift, down arrow key. And you can see that I've now selected all of the cells within the range, excluding the header row. You've now completed Lesson 2.8, Auto-Select a Range of Cells.